We face a big problem with the population explosion. Since the year 2000, the humankind added 1.5 billion people. And until 2050, there will be another 2.5 billion added. Then we will be 10 billion people. And it could be much more later. Particularly in Africa, the population is exploding and the African population will double by 2050. Everybody wants a good life, but good life means you use energy, you use resources, we need more CO2 with the present system. So in a sense, there is a kind of incompatibility between the desire for more prosperity, for always more people, and on the other hand, the desire to protect the environment and to avoid massive climate change. This is the big problem we have. We could solve the climate problem by going into poverty. Yeah, to go into poverty helps the climate. You have no cars, you have no heating, you do not use planes, you eat no meat, and so on and so on. Yeah, okay, helps the climate, but is a much reduced life and is not what people want. So it's not that the rich people want to become poor to solve the climate problem. No, the poor people want to become rich and this adds to the climate problem. Only if we have some new ideas, situation could stabilize. So the most crucial question is, how could we eventually solve this difficult challenge? As always in history, the only peaceful, soft solution is technology. And what we need is new technologies to produce energy. And of course, we need emission-free energy, CO2-free energy. And if we would find a reasonable way to produce lots of such energy at reasonable prices, then things would look much better than they do in the moment. Okay, we have a second option, which is complementary to a new form of energy. This is a so-called nature-based solutions. That would mean we cooperate with nature by reforestation. For instance, on 1 billion of hectares of degraded soils in the tropics. We can do a lot with humus formation in agriculture. We can protect rainforests. We can protect wetlands. Nature-based solutions are interesting in so far as they are the only area where more prosperity goes hand in hand with less CO2. This is totally unusual, but in nature-based solution it works. Therefore, they are among the best we can do. We should do this in any case, and we have to combine it with reasonable solutions in the field of energy. Solutions in the field of energy means energy that you can pay, so it must be more or less not more expensive than today, but it should have no negative impact on the environment and no negative impact on the climate. That is what we want. Now, the starting point always is the renewables, the renewable energy we produce today. We do it from wind, or we do it with solar panels. And so what we try is to catch the energy from the sun. And that is then translated into electricity. And on the route to climate neutral electricity, there were considerable progress steps in the last 20 years. So yeah, we achieved something. The problem is, however, that with electricity, we can only handle half of the problem of our civilization. So if we go to cars, or if we go to planes, or to ships, or to produce steel, or to do chemistry, then with electricity alone, things don't work. So for instance, for cars, we need something else than to concentrate on electric cars alone. There's a lot of problems with electric cars, but the biggest mistake is to think this car and then electric trucks and buses and everything is a solution for the world to have a climate neutral world with a wonderful mobility. This cannot be paid for. The green energy is not available. We have enormous problems with resources, with the batteries and so on. So we need also something complementary to electricity. So what we need is the green hydrogen as a starting point. Usually this is done by electrolysis. We need for that the energy, the green energy. We need even extra green energy because there are losses, because that is not the most efficient process. But this needs not a problem if we can have enough green electricity cheap. Cheap is the essential point. If the electricity is cheap, then efficiency is no longer the central topic. And cheap means we should have 1 kilowatt hour for at most 2 euro cent. So the essential question is how to get into enormous amounts of quite cheap green energy and where to produce it. Many people think it is because there is more sun, and there is somewhat more sun, but is that not the essential point? The essential point is that we have the land, because the energy masses we must produce need solar fields. If you think it to the end, it's hundreds times hundreds of kilometers. A desert is wonderful because nobody has any claims. And the nice thing is also there is no people to protect the environment because there is no people and there's no environment. Yeah? So that makes it enormously more easy to do something. And as we do not have much time, we have to use this potential. At the moment, the work is starting to initiate the first really substantial projects to do that.